Welcome back to The Rhode Show. This morning in The Buzz, we all love mom and we're ready to celebrate Mother's Day this weekend. But there are some things that we just should not say to her ever. And Etiquette List has some of the things mom doesn't want to hear most. Like, you look tired. Are you tired? You look tired. Or, do you work? Or how about this? You look like such a mom. Or how about, oh my, you have your hands full. Or next, that top is so flattering on you. And that may be said in a creepy way. If that were my child, I'd blank, fill in the blank. So ladies, what bugs you the most that people say to you?
I think I probably heard all those at one point.
Really?
You don't just let it roll off your back.
Well, it's kind of like sometimes when you become a mom, right? People think it's free reign to make any comment.
Like, are you wearing those mom jeans again, Mom?
My daughters will say to me now that they're getting older and sort of interested in fashion, you're really wearing that to work today?
I have never said that, Emory. So.
That's right? My girls. There we are. Always there to support us.
I remember even being at the market when we were a lot younger, too, and whenever someone would say, ma'am, thank you, ma'am, it's just like that would kind of irk you a little way. But I've gotten that now.
Really?
And I'm like, I know why it bugged her so much. I'm like, thanks, ma'am.
Right,
I'm like,
right.
I'm already a ma'am. I'm already at that point. Okay.
You're like, I can be a miss.
Yes.
And it's tough for moms. Moms have to juggle, you know, as dads do, but moms are a lot of times take the brunt of it, of raising the kids, of trying to work all day, also trying to make sure that, you know, everything else is taken care of. And I say that because my wife is sitting next to me, but taking care of, like, bills. And it's a long day for a lot of people. Plus, you know, in our family, we have two girls. So let me tell you, when there is drama or something like that, thank God we have the dog, because I go, you know what? I think the dog needs to go for a walk. I'm taking the dog for a walk.
That's where I go. So
and that's true.
It is true.
So moms, they don't get the credit that a lot of times, you know, most of the time, that they deserve.
Or the dog, I guess, for the break.
Thank God for the dog. That's all I can say.
When this negative comment's coming from other moms and other women, I think that's coming from almost like a jealousy or, you know, an inadequacy maybe that they feel, that they think, let me see, maybe it's not as good as, you know, it seems to be for them. Or
Mom, do you ever feel like you get negative comments?
Sometimes I think people are ignorant. It's just that. They don't realize what comes out. There's no filter.
Right, right.
And I try not to take things like that personally. The older we get, I think it happens.
That we realize
I think you get to a point that you don't care.
Exactly. That's right.
You don't like me, so
when you're a new mom and your kid's a little and you're, you know, hearing criticism from, you know, a stranger at a store.
And then you feel guilty kind of maybe too. Yeah. Anything shoot out at you that you've heard? In particular.
Before you say it, that red light is on and that camera's on. Watch what you say.
Does it bother you more when other moms say it or when people that aren't moms and they're like,
other moms say it, it hurts more, because when someone who doesn't have kids or has no clue says it, you don't know what you're talking about.
But
this one, it's coming from another mother that, you know. I think there's a lot of guilt that goes with motherhood, and you probably always, you know, wondering if you're doing the right thing, no matter how hard you're trying, you know, is it good enough? So.
Yeah.
Well, women are just tough in general. I think that we all do it. No one's perfect, but women tend to be really hard on one another.
Yes.
Do you think there's anything that we shouldn't say to Dad?
Remember, you gotta go home.
Or maybe there are things you should say.
Oh no, I think our situation with just the three of us, we communicate. We're very sensitive about each other's feelings. I think so.
And if other people say anything, we just brush it off our shoulder and say we don't care.
I think if you had a stay-at-home dad, I don't think he'd be criticized in the park or wherever.
Right. Yeah,
right. Tend to want to help him out.
This has been quite the counseling session we've had today, and we won't even charge you for it.
And it's a good thing it's over. we put everything out to Facebook every day and to our Twitter followers. So here's what a couple of them are saying. Brian Bowden, he's weighing in today, and he says, things not to say, are you ever going to lose that baby weight?
Nice, Brian. Attaboy.
Or when are you due when they're not even pregnant?
Yes.
That's not a good one.
Mark Anthony Simonson says, mentioning how long it seemingly is taking to lose all that, again, the weight gained during pregnancy. Happy wife, happy life. And he laughs.
Mm-hmm. I agree with that.
And Sloppy Joe, she weighs in today and says, criticism of a child's behavior brings out the inner mother beer.
Yeah.
Partially because mothers take that as a personal insult to their parenting.